Welcome to the Trader Reviews channel. Make sure you hit the bell notification and check mark the box so you won't miss anything on my channel.
Straight up reviews, 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 straight up reviews.
What's going on, y'all? What is up? What is up? Yeah, the annoying fat ass gamer is back at it again to get on your nerves like a gnat all up in your day on face out there. I hope a lot of you guys been having a great day, and like I said, y'all, it's about to go down this week. Today is Monday. We got all the way until about Friday until the weekend comes along. Because let me tell you, before I get to this microphone, like I'm about to wrap some shit up on, yeah. So yeah, I joined One Life Fitness, and this time, y'all, I'm going to keep up with it. It's hard being fat, y'all. Don't ever be fat. If you a skinny little motherfucker, don't ever be fat. Fat problems arises, and you just gotta just fix it. So anyways, how's everybody out there doing today? Make sure you guys go pick up Donkey Kong Country right there. That just got released for the Nintendo Switch as well. I wanted to bring a response videos to this great YouTuber by the name of GAMEOVER86. What is up, GAMEOVER86? You guys hop on over there and go subscribe to his channel, watch his videos. Also, if you got, you know, you can't find his channel, go down to the link of the bottom of the description as well and click that link and go to his channel as well. You know what I'm saying? He got some pretty cool videos. And you guys already know, Straight Up Reviews love to hold down great YouTube gamer communities as well on YouTube and non-gamer communities as well. I wanted to do a response video to his three video game possessions. And I'm going to show you guys the games that he showed on his video minus one game that I don't have. And right here, I'm going to bring it back old school style for you guys back in the retro days to school you new gamers out there, you new age gamers of this age era that don't know shit about gaming out there. Ninja Turtles 2, baby, right there, as you guys can see in my hand right here. And this game right here, I grew up off when I was a teenager growing up, still shitting in my damn drawers. I'm pretty sure that a lot of old school gamers from back in the 80s and the 90s got this Ninja Turtles 2 arcade game in their collection from back in the day when Nintendo used to be king of the top of the gaming. They still are, you know what I'm saying? When I first played this game before it got released on Nintendo, I started out playing the Ninja Turtles 2 arcade game. I think it was like Turtles in Time or something like that. And then it got released, you know, on Super Nintendo, which I got that in my collection as well. Ninja Turtles 2 is a great game. You know, back in the day when retro gaming was just on top, I love the old school game because they had passion, they had quality in their games, and there wasn't a lot of, you know, just, you know, DLC bullshit going on right now. They need to bring it back, so make sure you guys, you know, go pick this up to the new school gamers that, you know, actually want to play this game as well. GAMEOVER86 showed Ninja Turtles 3 right there called The Manhattan Project. But yeah, this is basically my favorite into the series because for the simple fact is that I lost this when I was younger and I was so daggone mad. As a matter of fact, I lost both of them. And I'm pretty sure a lot of you guys is probably asking, hey, Straight Up Reviews, where's Ninja Turtles 1? I hated that game. That's the reason why I didn't even buy it. I don't want to buy games that I don't like. And, you know, sometimes I get to the point where it's like, well, I'm going to buy just having in my collection, just complete my little trilogy. No, I can't stand Ninja Turtle 1. And like I said, you know, that was the time when Ninja Turtles didn't even have all that color. It was all just red bandana up like bloods out there. But yeah, so check this video out because he showed three of the Ninja Turtle original games that came out on Nintendo back in the day. And I'm about to show it you guys right now into my video of my three video game collections in my possessions. You know what I'm saying? Right here. You guys remember? All you old school games better open your eyelids up because I'm about to just bring it back to your school, old school up in here. Ninja Gaiden 1. Oh, damn. You guys already know what Ninja Gaiden 1 is. And I'm pretty sure a lot of young kids are talking about, oh my gosh, what is Ninja Gaiden 1? I remember I played that mug on the PlayStation 3 and I played the one on the Xbox 360. Nah, you need to stick to that one because you don't know nothing about the old school. This is where it, you know, became. This is where it grew up off. This is where the original Ninja Gaiden is from, baby. The birth, the womb, the placenta sac. Everywhere you go. So anyways, I remember this game, you know, was my second Nintendo game, and, you know, it was actually presented by my cousin when he was playing Castlevania as well, and he was like, hey man, you gotta play this game. I said, okay, let me try it out. This game is challenging. Like, these games back in the day, you don't have continues. You know what I'm saying? You get like 10 lives, and you get like maybe one to two continues, and that's it. And you get way, way far, and then you and you're done. Game over. You know what I'm saying? Back in the day when games was really, really hard, and they need to bring it back to that, you know, to, you know, this era, because games today are too easy. Let me think. God of War for the PlayStation 4. That game is too damn easy. I'm beating the shit about that damn game. But we ain't talking about that right now. Then we got Ninja Gaiden 2, baby. This is right here is my favorite into the series right there. Every time I get to the end of this game, I cannot beat the last boss. I always end up with one life and one energy bar. And like I said, y'all, one day I'm going to beat this game. But hey, I keep on trying right there to, you know, play this Ninja Gaiden 3 right there, the Dark Sword of Chaos. Like I said, I like this one better than Part 1, even though Part 1 is, you know, where it came, originated at. But Part 2 was basically my favorite into the series as well. Then we got Ninja Gaiden 3, Ancient Ship of Doom. This game right here is very, very, very rare. Very, very rare. I mean, if you look at it right now, you're not going to really find it. You'll find it. And people are asking a lot of money for this copy. Because for simple fact is that when Ancient Ship of Doom got released, they didn't release any, you know, that much productions into making this game. And that's why when you get your hands on this, you need to keep this. This right here is the most, most challenging into the series ever. This will piss you off right there. And also, if you want to get it on Super Nintendo as well, make sure you guys, you know, you can get it, you know, on there as the trilogy. You know, all games in one NES cartridge as well. So, yeah, those are my three top video game possessions. I'm bringing it back old school retro style for you guys. And like I said, y'all, this is a response video to the homeboy named GAMEOVER86. Make sure you guys go check him out as well. Spread his channels out. Spread the Straight Reviews channels out. And like I said, if you guys want to see any more videos that we bring to the channel, that he brings to the channel, hey, just hit us up in our emails or our comments as well. Love y'all out there. Straight Up Reviews, baby. Ha!
Straight Up Reviews.